Today I'll discuss electrolysis process in electrochemistry. In electrochemistry, electrochemical cell and electrolytic cell, two types will be there. In electrochemical cell, chemical energy is converted into electrical energy, where the Daniell cell is example, in which anode and cathode, anode loses electrons and these lost electrons move through a wire and bulb glows and it goes into the cathode compartment. Likewise, the circuit is completed. So in this cell, chemical energy is utilized to bring the electrical energy. On the other hand, in the electrolytic cell, we use battery to bring the chemical change. Already we learned some electrolysis process in the metallurgy, especially in the refining of metals. In the refining of metals, impure metal acts as anode, pure metal acts as cathode, and some current is sent into that. That process is called electrolysis. In the electrolysis process, electrical energy is utilized to convert the chemical chain. The electrical energy we use is always a battery. Battery is a DC. In our daily life, we use electric current, that is AC. That current should not be used to do the electrolysis. Always we have to make use of the direct current DC. From where the direct current comes? From the galvanic cell or Daniell cell. So that is a simple difference between the electrolytic cell and electrochemical cell. Now, during electrolysis, two metal rods are dipped in and some chemical solution is taken. To that current is sent. And at anode and cathode, the process will be taking place. Look at one by one. I'll tell you. These are some examples. Electrolyte taken is fused in NaH. Electricity passes because of two reasons. One is the movement of electrons. The other one is movement of ions. So either electrons can move or ions can move. If electrons move from one place to other place through a rod, then they are called electronic conductors. If with the help of ions, the electricity move, then it is called electrolytic conductor. For example, if suddenly I put a finger, my finger into the electrical plug, then the shock will give to my body. Why? Because in our body, electrolytes are there. Electrolytes means sodium chloride, potassium chloride, so many electrolytes. The electrolytes move from one place to other place with high speed. As a result, it gives shock. Under normal condition, the movement of ions takes place in our body to maintain the blood pressure, regular blood pressure. So suddenly we feel some electrical shock because of abnormal movement of ions, because of some shock that is given to us. It is accidental. Right? So there are two kinds. Electronic conductors and electrolytic conductors. Here we are considering electrolytes. Electrolytes means the solutions having ions. Glucose is not an electrolyte because it has no ions. Petrol is not an electrolyte. It has no ions. For example, when electric current is sent into the petrol, no shock will give in. When electric current is sent into the glucose solution, there is no shock. But a pinch of salt is added to water, then it is conducts electricity. So electrolyte definitely contains ions. The ions move from one place to other place. As a result, the current moves. So basically, electrolytes have ions. So if no ions, no electricity. For example, urea solution, not electrolyte. Glucose solution, not electrolyte. Sugar solution, not electrolyte. Why? Because no ions. NaCl solution, electrolyte. KCl solution, electrolyte. All strong acids and strong bases are definitely electrolyte, because strong acids and strong bases completely ionize. In strong acid, H plus ion moves. in strong base OH minus ion moves. Likewise, all acids and bases are electrolytes. They are good conductors of electrolyte, electricity. All salts also good conductors of electricity. Likewise, electrolytes do have ions. That is a fundamental point you have to remember. Look at one by one. This is electrolyte. And I have taken fused NaH. NaH is actually solid. The solid is fused. Fused means it is converted into liquid state without adding water. If water is added, it is called aqueous. Without addition of water, if it is brought into liquid state, it is called fused. So here I have taken fused NaH. NaH is definitely ionic, Na plus and H minus. So in that solution, Na plus is there and H minus is there. Na plus is a cation, H minus is anion. Into that solution, two electrodes are placed and direct current is sent. Then the chemical changes takes place. What is happening? These are electrodes. Generally, platinum is written because these are called inert electrodes. Inert electrodes means these electrodes do not react with these ions. So any electrode which do not react with these ions are called inert electrodes. In general, chemistry or physics, inert represents with the platinum. Why? Because the platinum does not react with acids or bases or salts easily. So whenever you come across this platinum, it is generally named as inert electrode. That means that electrode is not having the ability to combine with any ion. That means chemically non-reactive, called inert electrodes. At anode. This, at anode always what happens? Oxidation takes place. At anode always oxidation takes place. At cathode always reduction takes place. So here cation Na plus, H minus anion. So H minus goes to anode. The ion goes to anode is called anion, or the cation goes to cathode is called cation. That is, ion goes to cathode is called cation. H minus changes to H2 and loss of electron. So at anode, what is liberated? Hydrogen is liberated. If I send 1 faraday of electricity, how much hydrogen is liberated? 1 gram. How much volume of hydrogen is liberated? 11.2 liters. Next, Na plus is cation. Cation goes to which electrode? Cathode. So at cathode, what happens always? Reduction. So gain of electrons and sodium. So sodium will be deposited at cathode. Hydrogen will be liberated at anode. Say 1 faraday current is passed. How much sodium is deposited? 23 grams. How much hydrogen is liberated? 1 gram. How much volume of hydrogen is liberated? 11.2 at STP. So these are the two inferences we have to understand. Finally, what happened? Sodium hydride is consumed. So NaH is vanishing out. This is one example. Next, come to NaCl liquid. NaCl liquid are fused. Both are same. In NaCl, no water is added, but it is brought into liquid state. How? By increasing the temperature. That is called fused NaCl. Fused NaCl. So in NaCl, what kind of ions are there? Only Na plus and Cl minus. Once again, I have used what kind of electrodes? Inert electrodes. No reaction of these two. So at anode, what happens always? Oxidation takes place. So in this, what is anion? Cl minus. Cl minus changes to Cl2 and loss of electron. And what is cation? Na plus. And here same I have written. So sodium is liberated. How, if 1 farad of passed, 23 grams of sodium is liberated. How much volume of chlorine is liberated for 1 faraday? That is 35.5 grams is liberated and volume is 11.2 liters. That is already discussed in the Faraday's law. So if 2 faradays is sent here, how much? This is 2 moles will be liberated. That is deposited. Here 1 mole of chlorine will be liberated. That is 71 grams. And finally, what happens to NaCl? It is consumed completely. So this is with NaCl liquid. Now, come to this. NaCl aqueous. The difference between these two is absence of water but in liquid state. Presence of water in liquid state. So here, there is a competition between ions. What is the competition? Na plus is there and H plus is there. Cl minus is there and OH minus is there. From where these two ions are coming? From water, because we have taken water in that. In water, H plus and OH minus ion is there. Therefore, Na plus and H plus, Cl minus and OH minus. Now, we have to understand. these two are inert electrodes, that means no reaction with these. Now, at cathode, two possibilities, Na plus may be liberated, or hydrogen may be liberated. Na plus may be liberated, or hydrogen may be liberated. But anode, fluorine may be liberated, and OH minus may be liberated. Now, first look at it. At anode, chloride ion will be discharged easily. That is the important point we have to pick. OH minus ion is not easily discharged. The meaning of discharge is removal of charge from OH minus, removal of charge from Cl minus. It is not easy to remove minus charge from, that is OH minus. It is easy to remove minus charge from Cl, that is called discharge potential, or SRP values based on the SRP value. So in these two, which is easily discharged? Cl minus is easily discharged. Not easily discharged, OH minus. Hence, which is liberated at anode, chlorine is liberated. That is important point. Now, in these two, in the electrochemical series, hydrogen SRP is zero. Sodium SRP is minus. Lower SRP is a good reducing agent. That means easily not discharged. A good reducing agent, not easily discharged. That means the charge cannot be removed easily. What is the charge here? Na plus. What is the charge here? H plus. In simple, there is Na plus and H plus. Which easily takes electrons? Non-metal. There is Na plus and H plus. Which easily takes electrons? Non-metal. So hydrogen plus takes electrons. Sodium remains as such. That is called discharge potential. So in these two, which is discharged easily? Na plus. Therefore, the potential supplied to remove charge is less for hydrogen. So finally, in Na plus and H plus, which is easily discharged? H plus. So hydrogen is removed. So hence, it can be written like this. Look at this. H plus. Plus electron. And hydrogen is liberated. This is the one way. Or, water may be reduced because at cathode always reduction takes place. This or this, so both are right. H plus is discharged. It may be written like this. Or it is also written like this. Water gets reduced into hydrogen and finally changes into it. Tell me now. Cl minus is discharged. That means it is liberated at anode. And hydrogen is liberated at cathode. So what is the final solution? Na plus is remained and OH minus is remained. So finally, NaOH is formed. What is the pH of NaOH? Greater than 7. Greater than 7. Why? Because it is a powerful base. So NaOH pH is greater than 7. What is the initial pH? NaCl is neutral. NaCl is neutral. This is a, you have studied in the junior intermediate. The pH of NaCl is neutral because it does not undergo hydrolysis. So from neutral solution, what happens finally? Basic solution changes. So this is the important conclusions. This is the important conclusion. Now look at one more example. Come to this. K2SO4. K2SO4. Aqueous solution. Potassium ion and H plus ion are in the competition. Sulfate ion and OH minus ion are in the competition. And in these two, hydrogen SRP is zero. Potassium SRP is negative. Because they are all active metals. Copper, silver having SRP positive. Hydrogen is zero. Remaining active metals, S block metals, have SRP negative. So in these two, potassium is not discharged. Instead, hydrogen discharges. That is very clear. As in case of sodium and potassium. We have studied this. Now we are applying. Now these are bigger anions. Sulfate ion, nitrate ion. These are very bigger ions. These ions are not discharged easily. That means the charge present on the ions cannot be removed easily. So, in such a case, which is easily discharged? Hydroxyl ion. So, look at now. In these two, K plus not discharged. H plus will be discharged. Sulfate ion not discharged. OH minus ion is discharged. That means discharge potential of hydroxyl ion is less than sulfate ion. So, now look at this. These are inert electrodes. At anode, what happens? Oxidation takes place. Oxidation takes place. So, OH minus will be discharged easily. Hence, it is written like this. So, finally, what is liberated? oxygen at anode. So at anode, always oxidation takes place. Hydroxide ion undergoes oxidation into oxygen, liberation of oxygen. I think it is clear. No. At cathode, what happens? Reduction takes place. Reduction takes place, not K plus is not H plus. H plus reduction can be written like this or like this. This is the case. Right? Now look at anode, what is liberated? Oxygen is liberated. At cathode, what is liberated? Hydrogen is liberated. If 1 farad of current is supplied, how much oxygen is liberated? 5.6 liters or 80 grams. How much hydrogen is liberated? 1 gram or 11.2 liters. Likewise, the question may be framed. If K2SO4 is electrolyzed by sending 1 faraday, what are the volumes liberated at the electrodes? 1 faraday, oxygen is liberated at anode, that is 8 grams, that is 5.6 liters. 11.2 liters of hydrogen is liberated at cathode. K2SO4 remains unchanged. What is consuming? Water is consuming. So final inference, pH remains same because K2SO4 does not change. So no change in K2SO4. Only water is removed from that K2SO4. So pH as it is remaining same. This is the case with K2SO4. Right? Now, look at this example. Silver nitrate. In silver nitrate aqueous solution I have considered. In aqueous solution, H plus ion is there. OH minus is on there. Ag plus and NO3 minus. Two cations, two anions. Now the competition. In these two, SRP of Ag plus C is positive and hydrogen is zero. Whereas in the previous case, hydrogen SRP is zero and SRPs of these electrodes are negative. And now hydrogen electrode is zero, silver electrode is positive. So in these two, which is easily discharged? Ag plus. Higher SRP cations discharges easily. That's what we did in the previous case. SRP of sodium electrode is less than the hydrogen, hence hydrogen is discharged. And here, SRP of silver is less than hydrogen, hence silver is discharged. So in these two, silver is discharged. Now, in these two anions, bigger anions are not easily discharged. So OH minus is discharged. Now, based on that, here we have written. At anode, oxidation takes place. So this is undergoing oxidation, so oxygen is liberated. So whenever nitrate and sulfates are there, remember at anode oxidation takes place and oxygen will be liberated. Now at cathode, not H plus, initial Ag plus changes to silver metal. So this is the important conclusion you have to understand, because the SRP of silver electrode is positive than hydrogen electrode. Now finally, what is happening? In silver nitrate solution, silver is consuming, OH minus is consuming. Finally, what is left behind? HNO3. So in the solution, HNO3 is leaving behind. So what is that acid? Nitric acid is leaving behind. So pH is less than 7. Final solution is HNO3. Why? Because strongest acid is formed, pH is less than 7. That is the case. Next, sixth one. Aqueous silver nitrate is taken, but here I have changed this. Listen carefully. Platinum and platinum refers inert electrodes. Here, instead of platinum, I have taken silver anode. Here I have taken platinum cathode or silver cathode. Here it is platinum or silver. It doesn't make any difference in the electrolysis, but this makes difference. This anode is called active anode. If silver is used as anode, then it is active. This we got in metallurgical process. Impure silver act as anode. Pure silver act as cathode. At anode, silver ions are formed. At cathode, silver ions are deposited. So if this is not written here, if platinum is written, then there is no chance of that is a dissolution of this electrode. Now look at what happened here. Anode. At anode, OH minus is not forming. Instead, anode dissolves. Ag metal, anode dissolves into Ag plus and electron. the impure metal dissolves in the solution and Ag plus deposits on the cathode. So the anode dissolves. This is the anode, not the OH minus ion. So this electrode is active. That electrode dissolves. That is active means reacts with the OH minus, like reacts dissolves. So finally this happens. So this is the important conclusion at anode. Now at cathode, Ag plus at cathode, Ag plus, this is the Ag plus. I have written the same. Ag plus discharges at Ag. So what happens? Ag plus changes into Ag. So at anode, Ag changes to Ag plus. At cathode, Ag plus changes into Ag. What is happening? Weight loss at anode is equal to weight gained at cathode. Weight loss at anode is equal to weight gained at cathode. The same principle is obtained in metallurgy, in the refining of metals. Right? Now, look at this seventh example. Copper sulfate aqueous solution, platinum, platinum. This refers to nth electrodes. So, H and OH, copper SRPE is positive, iodine SRPE is zero. So, in these two, copper is deposited. So, here copper is deposited at cathode, just like in silver. And now, OH minus is discharged at anode. So, in the similar case, whatever we discussed in the Ag and O3 with nth electrodes, same will be forming with the copper sulfate and nth electrodes. So, this is the case. So, final solution is copper is depositing at cathode and the hydroxide ion is liberating into oxygen. So, final solution, what is left behind? Hydrogen and sulfate. That hydrogen and sulfate is called H2SO4. So, H2SO4 is formed. pH is less than 7. What is the solution color? Copper sulfate solution is blue color. That solution disappears and blue color disappears. Why? Because Cu plus 2 is depositing in cathode. So, Cu plus 2 will not be there. Instead, changes to Cu. Now, look at another example. Copper sulfate, same example. Electrode changed. Instead of platinum electrode, what electrode is taken? Copper anode. If copper is anode, that is active. So, if solution is known, in that solution, copper is there. If copper anode is used, then that anode dissolves. If silver nitrate solution, silver is used, then that anode is dissolved. So, similar. Fifth and seventh example is similar. Sixth and eighth examples are similar. So, finally, what happened? The copper will be dissolved. Anode dissolves into Cu plus 2 and copper plus 2 will be deposited. So, weight lost at anode is equal to weight gained at cathode. No change in the solution. Now, look at electrolysis, how it happens. In electrolysis, it will take like this. The solution is taken, and this is called electrolyte. Contains ions, examples NaCl, KCl, etc. All acids, all bases, right? All salts which dissolves in water. These two are electrodes. These two are electrodes. And these electrodes are joined like this. This is DC. DC means direct current. Direct current means battery. So there we use Daniell cell. This is electrolytic cell. This is Daniell cell. In our domestic life, we use AC, which is not used for the electrolysis process. If AC current is used to do the electrolysis, this will explode whenever this two electrodes are dipped in. So never AC current is used in the electrolysis process. Always a direct current, that is battery. In battery, you know very well, there is a negative plate and positive plate. That negative plate is called anode in the galvanic cell. Positive plate is called cathode. For example, if I attach this to the negative plate, this gets negative charge. If I attach it to another plate, to the positive part of the battery, that gets positive. So look at this. This is a negative end. This is positive end. So this plate is a negative. This is a anode. This is a cathode. Negative plate in the galvanic cell is called anode because there oxidation takes place. The negative plate attached to this plate is called cathode. This never be called as anode. This is called cathode because the reduction takes place. Why? Because cations come and reduction takes place. Look at this. If Na plus and Cl minus is taken, Na plus comes here. So the process of reduction takes place. So that is called cathode. Now, this will be positive. And this is called anode. These ions will go here. So anion go to anode. Cations go to cathode. At cathode, always reduction. At anode, always oxidation. So there should not be any confusion in this. In Daniell cell, anode is represented as the negative pole. There oxidation takes place. In electrolytic cell, negative plate is called cathode. At cathode, reduction takes place. The fundamentals never change. The only difference is this negative plate is attached to this plate. Therefore, this acquires negative. This is called the movement of electrons. From negative to electrons will come here. So what is happening? At cathode, what reaction takes place always? Reduction. So here, Na plus plus electrons change it to Na. So reduction takes place. At cathode, at anode, oxidation takes place. At anode, Cl minus changes to Cl2 plus electrons. Now, electrons move in this and go in this direction. So electrons will enter from negative plate to the solution. So in solution, current is due to movement of ion. In electrodes, current is due to. Therefore, this is the way of moving electrons. The opposite direction is called electric current. The opposite direction of the movement of electrons is called current. So from negative plate to, from negative plate, the electrons enter into the solution. From positive plate, the electrons leaving from the solution. So likewise, this movement of electrons takes place. The current will be in this direction. So this